In this video, we provide a quick walkthrough of our paper, Pixel Adaptive Convolutional Neural Networks. Convolution is the fundamental building block of modern deep neural networks. A major property of standard convolution is the spatial sharing of weights. Although widely considered as an advantage, spatial sharing is not always ideal. Consider the convolution operation on this image. The same set of filters are applied everywhere in a sliding window fashion. Moreover, once learned, the same set of filters are applied on all different images, even if the images depict very different type of scenes. In other words, convolution is content agnostic. Filters optimized for one scenario, for example, sunny days, are not necessarily a good fit for rainy days. CNN can use a large number of filters to mitigate this issue, which, however, requires more parameters and potentially also more training data. In this work, we propose a content-adaptive operation that still retains several favorable properties of standard spatial convolution. In a standard spatial convolution, filter W is multiplied with local patches in a sliding window fashion and generates output V prime. In our layer, we consider an additional input F, which itself can come from some other network layers. A kernel function K, which we call adapting kernels, is applied on F and compares F on each pixel with all other pixels within its filtering neighborhood. The result is then used to modify the filter weight W for the current position. Because the filters are adapted differently across pixel positions, we call our operation pixel adaptive convolution, or PAC in short. In definition, the only modification from a spatial convolution is the added term representing the adapting kernel K. Despite being a simple modification, PAC is highly flexible and can be seen as a generalization of several widely used filters. Here are a few examples. It is already obvious from the previous discussion that spatial convolution is a special case of PAC with a constant adapting kernel. By defining F as pixel color and K and W both as Gaussians, PAC can represent bilateral filtering. PAC can also represent pooling operations such as standard average pooling, and more recent techniques such as detail preserving pooling by defining a different kernel function K. PAC is flexible and we expect great potential in applications. As a first use case, we demonstrate the use of the transposed convolution variant of PAC for joint upsampling. For depth upsampling, our network can successfully recover details not visible in the low-res signal. Similar results can also be obtained in optical flow upsampling. As a second use case, we show that PAC can replace approximated high-dimensional filtering typically used in CRFs. A sparse pairwise connection pattern is achieved with the dilation option of our layer and helps provide faster inference on GPUs. We can produce finer visual details for some outputs and also report improved overall accuracies. We also propose a way to use PAC to easily leverage existing architectures and pre-trained models, which we call hot-swapping. Given a pre-trained network, hot-swapping directly replaces some comp layers with their PAC counterparts and retains the pre-trained weights as initialization before further fine-tuning. We show that hot-swapping can bring consistent performance improvements for semantic segmentation while adding minimal computation. In summary, PAC is a content-adaptive filter that generalizes several existing techniques. We demonstrate its use cases, including joint upsampling, efficient CRF inference, and network layer hot swapping. Please refer to the respective sections for more details. Thank you.